Now, I'm not one to gossip, but I will bring you the tea. Welcome to Chronicle Speaks.
Please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Mm-hmm. Eh? Yes.
Look at you.
Child, they say you don't know what you got until it's gone. The absence of new episodes of The Wendy Williams Show just goes to show how much of a goat Wendy truly is. Child, these other daytime shows are dry, lackluster, and all in all, can I say, straight out boring. We all have been awaiting Wendy's return. Child, Wendy's waiting right along with you. Your girl Wendy done went and got a $4.5 million condo in New York, and they say when it comes down to Wendy Williams and her show, sis is like,
I'm not going back.
Baby. But before we get into all of that, be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell for notifications so you don't miss out on any of this tea. Now let's get back into it. Wendy's show has gone from a September 20th start date to October 4th and then to October 18th. Now, they're still going to return on the 18th, but Wendy won't be there. And before I get into that, I want to get into this for a quick second. I kind of figured that would happen, and that's why they teach you those context clues back in grade school. The last time they reported that Wendy would not be returning on October 4th. However, we plan to return with new shows on October 18th. We, not we indeed, but we. Child, they knew sis wasn't ready, and word on the curb is that Wendy is over the show altogether. The latest announcement that came from Wendy Williams' Instagram page yesterday says the following. The Wendy Williams Show will start airing originals on Monday, October 18th, with an exciting lineup of guest host and panel to be announced shortly. Wendy continues to be under medical supervision and meets with her medical team on a daily basis. She is making progress, but is experiencing serious complications as a direct result of Graves' disease and her thyroid condition. It has been determined that more time is needed before she is able to return to her live hosting duties. Wendy is a valued and stalwart member of Debmar Mercury family and has been so for 12 years. We want her health to be her top priority. As soon as she's ready, she will be back in her treasured purple chair. We very much appreciate the respect for Wendy's privacy as well as all good wishes from her fans, station partners, and advisors. Now, according to Page Six, staff returned to the office this week after working from home due to Williams' ongoing absence. Sources told Page Six that the show has also been reaching out to past guests to see who's around next week. It wasn't a specific day mentioned, one insider familiar with the situation said. They're trying to gauge how many past guests they can load up to appear for a show. Now, as you recall, before when Wendy was sick, they had several guest hosts as well, including Sherry Shepherd, Jerry O'Connell, Kiki Palmer, and Nick Cannon, who actually has his own daytime show, which is also produced by Debmar Mercury. Now, sources close to the show say that Nick Cannon could possibly be groomed to take over Wendy's spot with his daytime show. However, both shows are syndicated and it's not that easy. They're trying to gauge how many past guests they can load up to appear for a show. Multiple sources have told Page Six that the delay of Wendy Williams' show is starting to become a huge problem for station affiliates and advertisers. As you can imagine, these advertisers are paying for Wendy Williams. Not Nick Cannon, not Sherry Shepherd, not Kiki Palmer. They're paying for Wendy Williams, so the fact that they're not getting her is becoming an issue. Now they've gone to scraping up hosts to see who they can possibly get during a pandemic. I just don't see this happening, but hey, Debmar Mercury, if you like it, I love it. Now, according to OK Magazine, Wendy Williams fans called for the talk show to be canceled as the host battles ongoing health issues. They're saying it's time. One person writes, I understand the money and the jobs behind this, but it's time for the show to come to a close. Wendy's health and life is more important. Another person writes, cancel the show, Wendy. Stop holding on to something God clearly wants you to end. Get well and stay well. Now, we all know that Wendy's health issues and complications are very well the reason why she's unable to return to the show, but we also know that Wendy's alleged drinking every day prior to checking herself into a psychiatric hospital recently, more than likely due to the stress from her life completely changing as her husband has moved on after their divorce to be in an open-to-the-public relationship with the very woman that he cheated on Wendy Williams with for 15 plus years, Miss Sharina Nicola Hudson. For years, Sharina Hudson was like a caged bird, having to live a secret, unable to express her love for her man because he was married. Now that the marriage is no longer, sis has been eating it up, taking pictures, taking videos, showing off Kelvin, honey, and spending money that does not belong to her because it was originally made from Wendy Williams' earnings. So yes, I do believe that the Graves' disease and the lymphedema and other illnesses have been bothering Wendy, but I definitely feel like Kelvin and Sharina are an illness that have been bothering her as well. Well, one illness that Sharina Hudson was very privy to prior to meeting Kelvin Hunter is an illness that Wendy will never see in her life, and that's the illness of brokenness. Wendy says, I might be broken, but I'll never be broke. Catch them tees, Sharina. Wendy Williams has went off and bought a $4.5 million condo. Sis say she ain't worried about that. Now, one thing our girl Wendy Williams knows how to do, and that's live lavish. Wendy recently bought a $4.5 million condo in New York's financial district. Now, y'all know previously, Wendy was renting a $15,000 a month condo, but now Wendy has finally found a place to call home. Something nice and cute with a beautiful view, 3 bedrooms, upstairs, downstairs, a place where she can go to the sauna and also a pool because you know our girl loves to swim. Now I can tell Wendy is definitely handling things on her own because when she was with Kelvin, her homes were typically put in a name of a corporation, but now Wendy just wants to go by Wendy. Wendy is putting the homes in her own name. Seems like Wendy has downsized her life from the big spacious homes to living like a woman who's looking to retire soon. A place with a nice view, somewhere for her cats to call home, and she can call it a day, child. It does not look to me like Wendy Williams plans on returning to her show or her fabulous purple chair anytime soon. And in all honesty, with the things that she's accomplished in her lifetime, I think she'll be okay either way. Wendy has the funds and she also has the credentials to open up a podcast, a radio show, anything that she wants. She just does not have that love that she once thought she had. Either way you look at it, prayers out to Wendy. I know that any decision you decide as far as where you want to be with your career, your real fans will be behind you either way. Now what I need to do is hear from you. What do you think about everything going on in the camp of Wendy? Did you really feel like she would be making a return to her show? Or did you kind of feel like more than likely they would either cancel the show or be bringing on guest hosts? Leave a comment and tell me what you think. And as always, we'll talk about it down below. Talk to you guys later. Bye. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and hit the bell for notifications so you don't miss out on any of this tea.